Pharisee.
He appeared only to his loved ones. So as he rose up, Mary was the first one to see him. So wherever there is a resurrection, there is a mystery of love. Who was the other one who loved him? Peter, James, and John. So when Elijah was going to be raptured, who was around him? Elisha. He said, Elisha, I'm going to
Jordan.
And he said, Elisha, you stay here.
We're not doing
more. I'm going to Jordan.
Jordan.
And Elisha said, no, we will go together.
Elisha returned to the
man. We will cross Jordan together.
We don't say Jordan more.
So Elijah opened Jordan by the power
Elisha
of God.
Abule Jordan
and they crossed over.
Yeah, Baba feet.
So when they crossed over, Elijah said to Elisha.
Elijah wrote Elisha.
He said, you have been a real friend.
Hi, salute mutwala wa mutro.
Now that I am going, ask what you will. What do you want? And he said, I want the double portion of your spirit. And Elijah said, you have asked for a very hard thing. But if you see me go, if you see me go in my resurrection, that power inside of me, it will come on you. There is a mystery. If you see the power of God work on another believer, and you see it, that power will come upon you. So the Bible says, dead in Christ shall rise first. Remember all those who died before, they are in their theophanies. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So those who died first will appear. What raises them? The voice. What are you hearing today? The shout. What will take us to heaven? The dead and the living. The trumpet. All these three things, they are in the seals. When Brother Branham went to the sixth dimension, there were believers who believed this message. So what you are hearing is the shout.
So
those people who are in the sixth dimension,
but
what they will hear is the voice. The same voice that said, Lazarus, come forth. That's the voice of Christ. That's what will raise them. But you who will be in this body, when they rise first, they take up their glorified body. Remember, theophany, the celestial body is the most glorified body. So the rapture will take about 40 days. Because when Jesus rose, he moved on earth for 40 days, meeting his disciples and fellowshipping. So that same thing will happen when your loved ones get up. They won't go straight to heaven. They'll come and start and look for you. And they know where you are. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when your loved ones get their glorified body, that glorified body can go through the wall. Maybe you are sitting on the dining. You just see maybe your loved one. Maybe your father who died already. He's already young, maybe 18 or
19.
The moment you see him, he sees you. Already, you are quickened. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's the mystery of love. So this is the season for the rapture. So maybe like you're walking, a strange face will just appear.
You
just say, this is so and so. The moment you see him,
how mona face
sees you.
How mona.
So those loved ones, they know where you are. Remember the day Elijah got raptured. That particular day, he visited Elisha. Hallelujah. So they went together. And when Elijah got raptured, Elisha saw it. And power came in him. So when they went to Jordan, hallelujah, he took the rope and hit it. The power was already inside of him. He says, where is the God of Elijah? And let the Jordan open. When you behold your loved one,
he
will put power inside of you. That's the power that will change your body. See the message adoption? Abraham says, for if we believe that Christ rose and died and rose again, even so, those that are asleep in
Christ
will God bring with him. For we say unto this by the commandments of the Lord, that which we alive and remain until the coming of the Lord shall not prevent or hinder those which are asleep. For the trumpet of God shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. This celestial body is come down and put on earthly glorified body. Which who are alive and remain shall be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. So the dead in Christ will rise first. I really want to make an emphasis on that. When you see them,
how about
they see you?
How about
you are quickened? So this is the hour. Any day from now, to meet your loved one
in
a young age, and immediately you are quickened. So the rapture is a mystery of love. So Lazarus, for him to rise up, mother had to be there. And Mary. Those were his loved ones.
The
rapture will only happen among the loved ones. Remember Brother Bosworth and Brother Branham. They had love. There was a contact. So Brother Bosworth fell in a train. The angel of the Lord came to Brother Branham, and Brother Branham was driving up the hill, and God started driving, and he saw a vision, Bosworth falling from a train, and the angel said, pray for your friend, pray for your loved one, and immediately Bosworth was healed. So the supernatural only happens when there are loved ones. Remember when Jairus' daughter, when she died, who was caught in the room? For Jesus to raise Jairus' daughter, people were crying, and Jesus kicked them out, of the room. And he called the father and the mother, and he called his loved ones. He called Peter, James and John, and he closed the door. He said Thomas out,
Thomas
says Judas out.
Judas,
he only called his loved ones. So that atmosphere of love, Jairus' daughter was raised. So when Jesus was going into the rapture, whom did he call to witness his rapture? He didn't call Herod, because he was not his loved one. He didn't call the Pharisees, because they were not the loved ones. He called his 11 disciples, because Judas had died. And he says, come and see and witness my glory. And Judas was dead already. So they went to Mount Olives, and Old Testament saints. And Jesus, before he went, he says, bye. And immediately he was quickened. He was raptured. So the rapture will only happen when there are loved ones involved. So let's stay in love, and let's love one another. So for 40 days, we'll be seeing our loved ones. And after 40 days,